This is the Church of St. Olaf in Chester. Although this church itself, of course, doesn't date from Viking times, its name is an indication of the Viking history of Chester.
Like London and Canterbury, Chester was originally a Roman settlement.
This map indicates the extent of the Roman Empire. Particularly here, their holdings in Britain. This is a model of the Roman city of Chester. When the Roman legions were recalled, like the rest of the Roman settlements throughout Britain, it was left defenseless against the Viking raids. I'm standing on the medieval walls surrounding the city of Chester, England. The medieval castle is behind me. In the 8th and 9th centuries, another violent, warlike group of invaders arrived on England's northern shores. This time it was the Vikings. And much like the Anglo-Saxon invasion, the Vikings came first in raiding parties and eventually came with settlers who settled and, of course, brought with them their language. Eventually, the two warring factions decided to divide the country along a line running from approximately here in Chester, southeast to the English coast. Under the leadership of King Alfred, the king of the Anglo-Saxons, this line was known as the Danelaw. In some parts of England then, we had the Viking settlers living side by side with the Anglo-Saxon settlers. Of course, they talked with each other, they traded with each other, they intermarried. And eventually, words from the Viking language became intermixed with Old English.